paper knees ain't falling die. I guarantee a death in life. Love is guaranteed strife. Whether or not you were my wife, if you give up every time, I choose to live another life. Replace the old up with the new. Every time you are confused, you are confused, you are confused.
Maple leaves. It's Craig and Celia X. It's Kevin here with the G-Free Show, and today for Media Monday, I wanted to talk about an article that was posted on the New York Times just on Friday. So what this article was saying is, you know, is everyone, or should everybody be gluten-free? And the author, I can't remember their name, but they actually have celiac disease, so it was kind of interesting, you know, for their perspective. But I expected, since the article was, you know, should we all be gluten-free, that it would be talking more about that. It basically talked about this expo over in Sandy, Utah, and basically this guy from General Mills in, well, the division Gluten Freely. And General Mills is based just out of Minneapolis, so it's only an hour and a half from me. But General Mills is actually a company that I had applied for just right out of college, and I really wanted to work for them and, you know, get their whole gluten-free thing going. And then, you know, I kind of found out about this being a division, so something that I'd certainly still be interested in. But anyway. They were talking about this Dom Alcocer from Gluten Freely, who was, you know, passing out all kinds of, you know, different gluten-free products from General Mills, and just kind of his impact that he made over there. And I thought that it was very interesting. The guy seems like he's awesome and just someone that I would really like to meet. And then also they were kind of talking about, you know, the progression of celiac being, you know, more common, and, you know, the testing of it and the increasing rates of, you know, celiac, and just the fraction, I guess. So they were talking about Dr. Guandolini, I can't remember his first name, an Italian doctor, and then also Dr. Alessio Fasano, who is one that I've heard of and read many things from. Now, Fasano was the one that originally found that, you know, celiac was one in every 250, and he wasn't quite satisfied with those results. So he further, you know, investigated and did more testing and everything, and soon came to the number 1 in 133. Obviously, a lot of you have heard of the 1 in 133 organization. And then, you know, he also was mentioning, you know, one in every 22, you know, that are relatives of people with celiac disease, you know, they have that kind of chance of having celiac as well. So I think that's all very interesting, you know. And again, I was just kind of expecting more about, you know, the effects of people that don't necessarily have to be gluten-free, you know, that should be gluten-free. But I do know that there is a chapter of Brian Gantzman's book, Defeat Wheat. I had talked about it on the 100th episode, you know, just kind of gave a little plug on that one. I know that he has a chapter on, you know, going, I think it's 2 weeks of gluten-free, you know, and kind of seeing how you feel, how your energy changes, that kind of thing. I'm still excited to, you know, get that book and actually kind of tell you guys little tidbits about it and, you know, different things. But, you know, that's really kind of just what I want to talk about, is just the article and different things like that. I think it's just great seeing, you know, gluten-free articles in, you know, major publications like the New York Times. I think that's awesome. You know, it's just only increasing awareness even more. People that aren't gluten-free are, you know, happening to just kind of click on this link and just read more about it. I think that's just amazing, you know, for our cause. So that's really all I wanted to talk about today. But tomorrow I will be putting out an episode. It's going to be a Taste Test Tuesday with some Enjoy Life Crunchy Cookies. And yeah, that's really everything. So I will see you guys tomorrow, and yeah, take care.